Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast. I am Ashton Doctor, your Habit Coach. And today with me, we have a very special guest. He's the president of the Heart Care Foundation of India and the Confederation of Medical Associations of Asia and Oceanic, a Padma Shri awardee. And in the last few months, he's been a calm, confident and comforting voice in this whole new world of COVID-19 that we've been living in. Not seeing it as a fight, but how can we all live with it safely? And this is why I thought it was a perfect combination for the ethos that we've created out here on the Habit Coach Podcast. So I'm so excited to have Dr. KK Agarwal join us today. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us and discussing COVID-19 and all the fantastic work that you're doing with us today.
Thank you, Ashton, and all my viewers who are listening to this particular program. Hello to everybody.
Super. Doctor, you know, your approach to COVID-19 has been so dramatically different, right? Instead of spreading fear, you've been spreading knowledge and, you know, little tips, little tricks that people can be doing through it. How did you see this kind of an approach? How did you start this whole thing?
I say when I took over as the president of Confederation of Medical Association of Asia and Oceania. But before that, I'm talking about 2014 when I became the Secretary General of Indian Medical Association and attended the World Medical Association meet. And at that time, we were talking about that why the associations are not working together to find out solutions for possible emerging diseases.
Okay.
And the discussion there was that was the job of the WHO. That's not our job. So when I became the Secretary General at IMA, then the President of IMA, and then the I took over as the President of CIMAO, I took this as a challenge that emerging diseases in the country should be the responsibility of an individual doctor. And when I took over on 5th of September, I started talking about one of the things is to have a task force in every country where we can work on emerging diseases.
Lovely.
And suddenly on 7th of January, I wrote about Wuhan mysterious pneumonia. From 7th to 18th, I was writing about it, following it on a daily basis. And 18th January, we had the first meeting in Malaysia and Myanmar. That means in the morning, it was Malaysia. In the evening, it was in Myanmar.
Oh, wow.
And we had Malaysia Medical Association, Myanmar Medical Association, Indian Medical Association, China Medical Association, and Thailand Medical Association. We participated. By that time, Thailand had got one case. So there was a case already described in Thailand. And we started exploring those possibilities. And at that time, when I heard about the SARS and MERS in the past, the experience by other countries, I was presuming that I need to do something. At that time, I never thought India will go into such a situation because our imagination was SARS and MERS never came to India. Maybe COVID-2 will never end up into India. But I started preparing myself and started learning myself. And I'm a person who likes to convert everything into formulas and teach. So my formulas are very common and very liked by the people. I try to be as basic as possible. And I correlate my science with Vedanta and with our epics.
Okay.
So I'll give you a simple example.
Please.
We have five different types of mind in Ramayana.
Okay.
One is called Sumanata Sumant. He has a man. Then we have Lakshya Man. Then we have Man Thara. Then we have Hanuman. And then we have Man Dodri. So there are five names in Ramayana where the names of a person has the word man into it.
Interesting.
So therefore we say, identify a Sumant in your life who advises you correctly. So therefore, Sumant is the advisor of Raja Dashrath.
Okay.
Correct advisor. Avoid people who create myths and doubts in your mind. Mantra advising Kekai and Kekai advising the Raja Dashrath.
Love it.
So therefore, whenever you are have a pandemic, you need Sumant and not mantra.
Correct.
And whenever you are in doubt, ask your consciousness to take the right decision. So your mind, which is directed toward consciousness, is Lakshya Man, the man with a Lakshya, man with an aim. And whenever your mind is disturbed, make sure your Mandodari explains your ego to suppress. So Mandodari suppressing Ravan all the time. And if nothing can be done, take the help of your Vayu, which is Hanuman, breath control. And with a breath control, direct your mind towards your soul and take a conscious-based decisions. So what is happening in this COVID scenario we have seen is everybody is disturbed.
Correct.
Everybody is having a fear of the unknown.
Correct.
And because of that, everybody wants to listen to a good thing, a claim. And whenever everybody wants to have a claim, no claim will become a viral unless you create a fear.
Yes.
So first you create a fear and then you give them a hope. That is the principle of making a statement viral. Therefore, we had lots of mantra coming in through messages who were creating fear. And after 2-3 days of that message, somebody starts writing about this is how this can be removed. And that's what the whole physiology of mantra is. So the mantra took over. Then I started reading about that is called as a Vidur Niti. When Raja, this Dhritarash was in problem and he was not getting his sleep. So he asked Vidur that I'm not getting a sleep. Today my message has been taken by Sanjay. And I don't know what he is going to bring back. Okay. Then Vidur said that for any sleepiness, for any stress, let me take an example of COVID stress. He says there are 5 reasons.
Right.
The first reason is that you have made a theft.
Okay.
So what is a theft in COVID? That you have withholded your symptoms. You have not told that you have met your girlfriend and she was positive.
Correct.
You don't want to disclose your secrets.
Correct.
So that is a theft. Second is passion. That you have an irresistible desire to meet your friends, your circle, alcohol, cigarette, movie, fun, chilling. And you go and don't tell anybody.
Correct.
Even if you have symptoms, you go. The third is loss of finances, which is happening. That is causing a fear. And because of that, you break the rules. Fourth is stigma. Stigma is your ijjat. And people start calling you as COVID and post-COVID and you have given me, you have given me. And the fifth is fear of unknown.
Correct.
And this fear of unknown came on 22nd of March when we said that this disease, at that time, everybody started thinking that this disease can be killing. When the first lockdown came, it came with an assumption that we want to prevent from a disease which can kill anybody and everybody.
Correct.
With that fear, everybody went into the fear. And the answer for fear is claims.
Right.
Because it's a new disease, everybody started putting claims. The fear further increased. Everybody got confused. That confusion is still going on. And there came people like me. I'm only one of the persons who is doing this job.
Yes.
And we started creating the facts. We started creating the education, the right education. And with that, our job was to use the principle of 100th monkey phenomena. And that also comes from Yoga Vashishta chapter 6, which talks about whatever 1% of the society think, rest 99% will think the same. And whatever 5% of the society do, rest 95% of the society will do.
Okay.
My job was to sensitize 1% of the population of the country that you can live with it. No fear, no fear, no fear. And I think I have been able to successfully sensitize 1% of the population. That's what you need.
Yes.
1% is sufficient to take care of the rest 99%.
And it's superbly done because, you know, the way that you've broken it down, saying that these are aspects that you're going to be feeling because these are a very you know, for the first time, it's actually somebody's life that they are actually looking at in this particular manner. And I've been staying at my farm for the last 6 months. Okay, so I've not been in a city at all. I went to Bombay just a few weeks ago. And it was so interesting to see the different mindsets that everybody has about this. Some people are taking it very seriously. Some people are not taking it seriously at all. And there are different mindsets around it. Some living in fear, some saying that now enough fear, too much fear. Is there a correct way for us to be thinking about this at this situation now, 6 months
in? I think the answers are very mathematical now.
Okay.
Everything is mathematical now.
Okay.
The first is, mathematical thing is, if you can prevent it, why not? If you prevent this, you will prevent all other respiratory diseases. You will prevent all water and foodborne diseases. So if you can prevent it, why not? Because the country will, at least 4 to 5 lakh deaths will be prevented if you prevent COVID-19.
Okay.
So the first message is, if you can prevent it, why not? Then comes a subset of it. How do I prevent? Okay.
Yes.
The first of all, prevention is, comes from our Vedic literature. This is called Chhatopchar Puja.
Okay.
Chhatopchar Puja, that means for every guest, when we say Atithi Devo Bhava, there are 16 steps of welcoming an Atithi who comes to your house.
Okay.
I'm only going to take 6 of them. I'm not taking the rest of them.
Okay.
The first is that, if you remember Sudama, when he went to Krishna, Krishna ne sabse pehle uske pair dhuye the. So first of all is that you need to wash their feet. And if you do that, large number of diseases goes away, which comes with the shoes to your house.
Lovely.
Because shoes are a silent carrier of infections from one place to another. You can't do it today. Give them a shoe cover, 2 rupees. So everybody who enters your house wears a shoe cover.
Lovely.
After that, Krishna gave Sudama. He asked him to wash the hands. After feed, wash hands. So here, you may not have that. Give them a hand sanitizer to wash. After that, Krishna said, "Bahut thake hue honge, haath muh dho lo." That is a tropical thing we say, that you are coming to my house, haath muh dho lo.
Correct.
So therefore, haath already dho liye. Now you have to wear, wash your mouth. Today we call them as povidone iodine gargles you do. Once you have done povidone iodine gargles, we tell them, then we give them mishthan. So give them gur. So as soon as they have washed their mouth, you give them gur. Indirectly, you are checking loss of taste.
Taste. I love it. Superb. Okay.
And then you tell them, unki upar mein itr fekho, so that they feel, oh my God, where I have come. What a good, but actually you are checking the smell.
Love it.
So you give them, check for the smell and the taste. And once you know that all of them have been done, then you do them a namaskar, where you see in the bottom, you see at his feet. So that your viruses go like this. And when he says, "Jeete raho," his viruses crosses my head.
Superb.
So, and then you make him sit at a high pedestal, because he's a guest, he's higher than you. So that when he's sitting at a higher pedestal, there is no face-to-face meeting.
Very nice.
So this is one call. This is called social engineering.
Social engineering.
This is social engineering, which costs nothing. These are called natural vaccines. These are natural vaccines to prevent. The second thing is that when you are living in a family, when Atithi is not there, then avoid face-to-face meeting. So first, for example, I have a table. I have a table. If I sit across each other, that's face-to-face meeting.
Correct.
So if I sit on the front and one on the side, it is face to side meeting. Okay. And if you see in our houses, there is a tradition for the person who is the eldest person to sit on the side.
Correct.
That's because he need to be saved.
Interesting.
Okay. Now, if there are two people of the same, these are called dining table etiquettes. Like you have an etiquette in the car.
Correct.
The person who is the most important will sit in the front with the driver.
Correct.
That means if I am driving a car, and there are two people, the person who is senior will sit with me in the front of the car. Because both of us are facing the front. We are not facing each other.
Correct.
Now, if two people are sitting of equal stature, they should sit side to side. That means they should sit face to face, side to side. Like this. So that their ear comes in front and doesn't face each other.
Correct.
If you are sitting face to face, then it has to be one person has to be at a lower and another person has to be high pedestal.
Okay.
Now, here you must understand why. This virus cannot walk, run, fly, dance, Google. It cannot do a googly. That goes like this.
Correct.
It cannot spin.
Yes.
Unless you make it spin. So this virus, once you throw it out with a moisture, it will go straight away.
Right.
It cannot go like this. It cannot go like this. Automatically. If I'm sitting like this, this virus will go in the front.
Front.
So therefore, whosoever is standing in front of me without a barrier, take it in. So the answer is barrier and no face-to-face meeting.
Interesting.
So therefore, if I'm sitting on a high pedestal, so therefore, if I'm standing and my guest is sitting on my sofa, I call my people on my sofa and I stand and don't look at his eye and we talk. It's okay.
Very interesting.
My guest is sitting on a sofa and I'm standing. So we are not having face-to-face meeting. Okay. And if we are not seeing each other, then his viruses will come and attack here, will go down. So that's okay. So therefore, the first thing which comes is no face-to-face meeting.
No face-to-face meeting.
And if you cannot avoid face-to-face meeting, use a barrier. Use a barrier. And that barrier, if you see, was a ghoonghat with elderly, high-risk people. That ghoonghat was with burqa in Islam. And that barrier was a mukhi patti in Jainism. It all started with Spanish flu in 1918 and people forgot about it.
Interesting.
So today, barrier is important when you are not been able to maintain a social distance, physical distance, or when face-to-face meeting is not possible.
Is there a particular kind of barrier that you prefer?
The first thing is no face-to-face meeting, if possible. So as much as possible, no face-to-face meeting. Therefore, if you see the mother giving a breastfeeding, there is no face-to-face meeting. The child may not get the infection because the mother is wearing a barrier. Even if the newborn is not wearing it, it's okay. And if you see, if the child, a primary class child is hugging the teacher, the infection is not transferred because there is no face-to-face meeting. Now, if there is a face-to-face meeting, then you must maintain either a distance barrier. The barrier, next barrier is a distance barrier. To be minimum 3 feet away.
Okay.
Then you come back to a minimum 6 feet away. If possible, you have a 6 feet away or a 9 feet away. You can have a 9 feet away. What is 9 feet if you are running? 6 feet if you are having a type of, you are speaking loudly, shouting, you are producing words which can go to a faster distance. But if you are speaking softly, 3 feet are sufficient.
Okay.
If you are sitting or talking to me from a distance of 3 feet, this virus will not reach me. But if this virus, so the first barrier is physical distancing, a distance of 3 feet, 6 feet if you are shouting, singing, and if you are 9 feet, if you are running or jogging.
Okay.
these 3 feet distance sometimes is impossible. Therefore, then you have to use a barrier. Now, barrier is of two types, medical barrier and a public barrier.
Okay.
Medical barrier is if you are having cough and cold, if you are sick, if you are symptomatic, then you and your caretaker must wear a surgical mask. Surgical mask. It cannot be anything else. So that surgical mask is for you, if you are a patient, and for your caretaker or people who are quarantining with you. These masks, once used, has to be put in a paper bag for 3 days before they are put into the garbage.
Okay.
All others have to use a fabric mask. All others have to use a fabric mask with multiple layers. Layer means folding. Now remember, cotton mask is only 17% filtrable. That means it is not the best. If you still want to use a cotton mask, cotton cloth, it has to be folded 4 times.
Okay.
It has to be folded multiple times. So therefore, the correct mask, the consistent use of mask and the correct mask. Now, difficulty with the cotton mask is, because this is porous, water absorbent. So therefore, if I use it, if the moisture comes here, it sticks to the cloth.
Right.
By mistake, if I put it like this, I had it.
Right, wrong way around. Correct.
If I'm wearing it like this, I take it out and now wear it like this, I had it. So this has to be very, very, very clearly, no cross spreading. No cross spreading. Third thing which comes in is hand hygiene. Hand hygiene is important, but much more important is face-to-face transmission.
Correct.
Much more is face-to-face than hand hygiene. Hand hygiene is very important, but later than the face masking. So therefore, when it, if you can prevent, why not?
Yes.
Why not? And if you get it, so what? If I get it, so what? I get so many diseases. This also I will pass on.
Correct.
So my answer is, if you can prevent it, why not? If I get it, so what?
Lovely.
For this so what, I have created all formulas of six.
Okay.
All formulas of six. And then I'll give only few examples of so what. If you get an infection, the first 6 days are the only days to observe.
Okay.
That means you only have to take care of 6 days. In heart attack, you take care of much many more days. Paralysis, you take care of many more days. Here we are talking about this, only take care of the first 6 days. Okay. So day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, day six. And out of these 6 days, 4, 5, 6 are more important. And out of these 4, 5, 6 days, day five is the most important. So we have zeroed down. That means now I created your fear from a sickness to 6 days.
Correct.
6 days to 3 days. 3 days to single day, fifth day. Now nobody can say, I don't have time, I can't take care of you, this and that. That's the first observation.
Right.
And the second is that even in these 6 days, I need you only 6 minutes. 6 o'clock in the morning and 6 o'clock in the evening.
Okay.
All six, six. So I only want your 6 minutes in the morning and 6 minutes in the evening. Rest of the time, you do what you want to.
Lovely.
And that at 6 o'clock in the morning, you do a 6 minute walk test.
Okay.
You do a 6 minute walk test and that's it. What you do is you brisk walk for 6 minutes, brisk walk for 6 minutes and check for six things.
That's okay.
6 minutes.
Lovely.
So on so walking for 6 minutes, you check what was my pulse before and after.
Okay.
What was my SpO2 before and after?
Okay.
What was my distance before and after? Did I get any cough? Did I get any breathlessness? Okay. And Did I became symptomatic? That's all.
Hmm.
If you find on 6-minute walk test, if your distance have reduced, you say every day when I used to walk for 6 minutes, I used to walk for 500 meters. Today, I could not walk for more than 200 meters. Oh my God, something is wrong. Let me talk to my doctor.
Interesting.
You say every time when I check my SpO2, there was no fall after 6 minutes.
Right.
Today, it is falling. Let me talk to my doctor.
Correct.
Every day after 6 minutes, today I'm feeling feverish after walking. That means temperature has come. Let me talk to my doctor. I have a feverish feeling today after walking. Oh my God, today after walking, I got a cough. Now, one of our Bollywood celebrity was admitted in a hospital only because he was walking and developed a cough. That was an indication of developing a pneumonia. Admitted in time, got all right.
Nice.
So 6 o'clock in the morning, 6 o'clock in the evening, check 6 parameters by 6-minute walk test. And if you do that, you will be able to detect that something is serious with you.
Okay.
Okay. There are 6 blood tests to do baseline and on day 3 and day 6. For those who can afford, but remember only one blood test, and that's C-reactive protein. If your C-reactive protein is rising, if C-reactive protein is rising, you have a problem.
Correct.
Okay, how do I remember? Whenever police is not there, you call CRPF, so reserve police. CRP. You just call them CRP test karalo, and that is going to take care of that.
Lovely.
So then when you are in doubt, go for a test. When you are in doubt, go for a test. Which test you do? Whenever there is a filtration of a thief in your house, whom do you call? 100. Whom do they send? The PCR van. Get a PCR test done. Get a
Love
PCR
it.
Test done. I mean, these are the formulas I'm giving you.
Right.
Hand washing, how do you do? Suman K. S-U-M-A-N-K. Sida. S for Sida. U for Ulta. M for Mutti. A for Anguta. N for Nakhun. And K for Kalai.
Superb.
So what I'm trying to say is this is how you need to remember in terms of the formulas. This is how you need to. There are 6 types of treatments available in COVID-19. There are 6 tests. There are 6 symptoms not to ignore. Everywhere you can remember thing by the word 6 with that.
Interesting. So this was part 1 of our conversation with Dr. Agarwal, where we were talking about COVID and his approach to understanding COVID and prevention. Join us next time on Thursday when we talk about what he thinks we should do if we do get COVID. And as you saw, his approach is so different from the way that we are currently told about COVID and the fears associated with it. I learned so much from listening to Dr. Agarwal and more from all the videos that he has on YouTube. Please don't forget to go and check out his videos on YouTube. You can just search for his name, Dr. K.K. Agarwal, A-G-G-A-R-W-A-L. And you'll find so many videos filled with interesting information. So don't forget to check that out as well after listening to this podcast.
If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashdin Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's Awesome180.
I hope you enjoyed that show. I'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Intel. It's been a great week on the network this week. If you haven't been paying attention, please do listen to some of the shows. We had Chetan Bhagat. This was the first returning guest on Cyrus Says. Do check that out. Great, great, great episode. We had Palak Zatake on Advertising is Dead. Really interesting conversation was had with Varun. We had another crossover on The Habit Coach. Zarina Poonawalla showed up over there to have a discussion with Ashton about anxiety and pressure. Begin the Journey with Ashir Vidyarthi continues to kill it. Please definitely do check it out. An old friend, Vijay Koshi, was on Storytellers and Storysellers. Do check that out as well. And I'd like to mention one thing. If you're a Tamil speaker, you should definitely check out our podcast, Kadai Podcast, Ponniyin Selvan. Kavita Jeeva has done a fantastic job to finish up her first story. It is the last episode, which just came out last Monday. Do check it out if you speak Tamil. It is an incredible achievement. Please do check that out. And with that, hope to see you again next week.
Are you constantly seeking happiness? Wondering how to make the most of every day? How not to let your inhibitions stop you from achieving your goals? It's now time to get your A-game on. It's time to unlock your true potential. Tune in to the Empowering Series with me, Zarina Poonawalla, to feel empowered in all genres of life. From behavioral skills to management skills, from health to relationships, from mental well-being to emotional well-being, and of course your finances. I've got you covered. With these tips and tricks from me, Zarina, and true life stories from my amazing guests, you're bound to bring your purest to the table. Tune in to the Empowering Series with Zarina Poonawalla every Thursday on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you listen to podcasts.